I love knitting. I love the way cryptic written instructions are compiled into physical artifacts with a range of both functional and aesthetic properties, using little more than a length of yarn and some ingenuity. I love its deeply technical, yet highly expressive nature. A bit reminiscent of both magic and programming. I love its history, its potential. I recently completed my Bachelor of Science degree in the field of creative computing. And throughout my studies, I kept being drawn to knitting and other textile arts as a potential way to translate my algorithmic or data-driven projects off the screen and into the world of the touchable. But here's the thing. Yes, I do love knitting, but an increasingly stale yarn collection and accumulation of unfinished objects has kind of forced me to confront the fact that perhaps I do not always love doing the physical process of hand knitting as much as I thought I did. Or at least not over the extended period of time required to make knitting by hand a realistic medium for exploring my more experimental algorithmic or computer-aided art ideas. I'd call myself an ambitious knitter, and even an enthusiastic one. But I'm neither fast nor prolific. So, for my capstone degree project, I set out to investigate the world of knitting machines, and, hopefully, to shepherd my loftiest yarn art dreams into the field of actually achievable project timelines by designing and building a knitting machine of my own. At this point, you might be saying to yourself, wait, I thought you said your degree was in computing, and I don't see any electronics on this contraption, so what does this have to do with computers? First off, although at first glance this machine may appear to be made of plastic and a few bits of metal hardware, it's also largely made of code. I planned and organized the whole thing like a software project, but instead of producing a website or an app, the source code produces 3D models for a system of physical objects. Second, I see this project and knitting machines generally as fitting into a movement of personal digital fabrication. A do-it-yourself culture of rapid prototyping, hardware hacking, and niche customization, enabled and empowered by digital technologies. Finally, the history of technology, automation, and computing is inextricably woven together with the history of textile production. And researching this project provided a useful lens to consider the social and philosophical implications of incorporating different sorts of technological advances into our creative labor. This is a big topic that feels especially relevant right now, as generative AI is getting a lot of hype and has become a hinge issue in labor disputes like the recent strikes throughout the entertainment industry. But this tension is absolutely not new, and it's not really clear-cut. For the scope of the academic project, I had three main objectives: to apply what I had learned during my study to design a knitting system that could be printed on a home 3D printer, to test the performance of the prototypes compared to hand knitting, partly to find out whether it actually did help me knit faster or more, as well as to evaluate its strengths and weaknesses and inform feature development, and to make some capital A art with it, based on work I'd developed earlier in the program. I also knew right from the beginning that once the scholarly part of this was wrapped up, if this ridiculous scheme worked, I would want to share it with other like-minded weirdos on the internet. This meant that even though my first priority was designing something that would work for me in the context of my projects, I also wanted to be aware of the choices I was making that might make it easier or harder to open source later. This included things like cost and availability of the materials and tools I chose, as well as trying to make the whole system modular and customizable with interoperable components that can be reused or independently replaced when upgrading. I think it's also important at this point to talk about things that were explicitly not objectives of this project, to set some context for what comes next. First, this is not a machine that autonomously knits for you. In my experience, when I say knitting machine, a lot of people imagine I'm talking about something like, well, a 3D printer. You feed some yarn in, press some buttons, walk away, and when you come back, you have a sweater. There are no doubt some very fancy machines that do work a little bit like this, especially when you look more towards large-scale industrial knitting. But the reality is that most domestic or artisan machine knitting, just like machine sewing, actually requires a skilled operator. I am going to talk a little bit later on about the more automated projects I looked at and why I chose not to follow in their footsteps, but for now I just want to be really transparent that knitting on this machine and most of the other domestic knitting machines that it's inspired by is a skilled handcraft that takes patience and practice to learn. Second, I want to be clear that this isn't a finished product that I'm pitching. It's an in-progress project that you are welcome to tinker with if you like. I'm putting a sort of alpha version of it out there, as is for now, and while I plan to continue working on features and making improvements over time, I'm only one person with limited time and attention to devote to maintaining it, so unfortunately I can't guarantee any level of personalized end-user support. The code and documentation will be available on GitHub, and along with these videos, I hope that if you see something you want or need changed, you'll feel empowered by those tools to customize your own machine and to share your changes for others to benefit from as well. Third, this contraption is more than a toy, but it's not exactly a piece of industrial strength machinery either. It should, I hope, go without saying that it's not intended for heavy-duty or commercial use. Coming up in this series, I'll be discussing a little bit of knitting machine history, how I researched this project, and some notable DIY and hardware hacking projects that came before. I'll also take you on a tour of the whole design process and the code, and talk about how you can build a version of your own. And of course, I'll demonstrate how to set up and use the machine, as well as a few other tools to get you started. If you're interested in finding out more about this project, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the big picture. Until then. Hey, so editing Sparks jumping in here with a maybe quick terminology clarification, because I've mentioned algorithmic art a couple of times, and then I realized that maybe some people, the only context in which they've encountered the word algorithm is kind of negative. Like when we talk about like the algorithm in social media, it's something that we're like really fighting against, and we talk a lot about the harms that it can do. But an algorithm in computer science is really just a well-defined set of instructions for accomplishing some kind of task or solving a particular problem. You know, maybe when you think about computer-aided art, because it's been so much in the news lately, the first thing that jumps to mind might be like the generative models like DALL-E and Midjourney, famously can't draw hands. I want to be clear that I'm not a fan of those. That's not the art that I'm interested in making with computers. And this is not really the time or place to do like a whole deep dive into the nuances of why and what the difference is. That is something I would love to talk about more later. So do stay tuned for that. But yeah, for now, I just wanted to clarify that like those applications are like a very, very narrow slice of what those words can mean. And they're not specifically what I'm talking about here. All right. Thanks. Bye. Stay curious.